Hey guys, today I'm going to be going over another frequently asked question that I get asked a lot about and kind of in slightly different ways, but I want to make this video that will hopefully kind of answer all the related questions kind of around this topic, and that is about the order of steps when it comes to painting and relating to like top coat, primer, decals, panel lining. I get a lot of questions like, should I top coat first before panel lining, or should I top coat after putting on decals, or should I use primer before I paint, or should I use top coat after painting and then before primer or before panel lining? All of this kind of stuff, pretty much any variation of those kind of steps I've been asked about before, probably. So hopefully this video will clear that up. I'll be going over just kind of basically my steps in terms of how the kind of the order that I go in, and also just kind of I think the important thing that you guys need to remember is it's really essential to understand the reason why we do each step in the process, because then if you know the reason why you do that step, then you can know whether when you need to do it and whether you need to do it or not, depending on what you want to do. So like I'll be going over that here in this. So I'm just going to go through my order here and then give you guys the reasons of why I do that step. And of course, I am no professional. If you guys do have any other sort of points where you think that I may be a little off, or I'm forgetting to say something, or you have any better suggestions, please do leave all of that down in the comment section down below. And those of you watching, do check out the comment section down below to see what other people are talking about. I think that'll probably be a good discussion there about this, but here is what I do. The first step is just a snap assembly of the kit. So just snap the kit up, just like how I usually do when I do my reviews and things like that. So that way, number one, you'll get an idea of just how everything goes together. You can also identify anywhere where there may be seam lines that you want to get rid of on the kit or not, or any other sort of adjustments you may want to make to the kit before you go in and start painting it. It also helps you identify areas where the parts of some parts may be showing or not. So, for example, if you just went in and just painted like some shoulder part, and the shoulder is kind of a common area where this can happen. You paint the outside of the shoulder armor, and then you don't realize that actually the underside of that shoulder armor will actually show a little bit, and you didn't paint that. So when you put it together, you have like one small edge of that part that's showing that's unpainted and it's the wrong color, and then you have to go back, take that part again, and then repaint that part, and then it's just kind of annoying. So when you build the kit all at first, you can have an idea of where everything is going to be showing, and you can make sure that you paint the part thoroughly. Also, I know one thing that people worry a lot about snapping the kit together first and then having to disassemble it, is then in the disassembly process, some parts are hard to get apart. You worry about breaking some pegs or something when you're pulling things apart, and that does tend to happen. There are some certain steps that you can take to make disassembly easier. For like when you have pegs that part plugs together, the male peg, you can just clip the end of that at a 45-degree angle. That makes pulling it apart a lot easier. I know the Ghost of Xeon has a great video on this on his channel, so I recommend you guys check that out. Again, in this video, I want to talk more about just the steps of the process. I'm not going to get into too much detail about exactly all the details about every single process in this. I urge you guys to just go ahead and do your own research about that. There's plenty of material out there for you guys to see here on my channel and other channels. So once you've got the kit all disassembled and separated and all everything, or however you want to do that, next step is to do primer. So primer, again, a very important step, and again, if you understand the reasons why we do primer, then you'll realize why it is important and where you want to do that in your assembly process. There's kind of three main reasons to use primer as far as I can tell, and that is, number one is to identify any imperfections in the surface. So maybe some area where there was a little bit of like a mold line on the part that you realize maybe you couldn't really see it well before, and then you realize, oh, now once everything's in primer, you can see all the details very clearly, and you can tell where some parts you may want to go back and do a little bit more sanding, or some parts where maybe your sanding was a little bit too rough and you need to sand it down a little bit more. So primer is a great way to be able to see all of that before you actually go in and start painting. Primer also gives you a neutral color base for your colors, whatever you're going to paint on a kit. So for example, you have a kit that the plastic is all like black, but you want to paint it in white and red or something like that. Just that gray primer will give you just nice neutral color that you can paint on and get your colors to exactly how you want them to be. You can also use other different colors of primer to adjust that for one way or the other. For example, white or pink primer if you're doing some really bright colors, or something you want a little bit brighter. Black primer if you want to do something a little bit darker. There's different other, and then you can also tint the primer in other different ways as well. But anyway, the third and probably maybe arguably the most important step of primer is that it gives you a connection between the plastic and the paint. The chemicals involved with the primer will help the paint to really grab a hold of the plastic, and then that will make the paints more resistant to chipping or cracking or anything like that when you're actually doing your assembly and all of that, and that is a very good thing. The third step is, of course, your base painting. So pretty self-explanatory. I mean, you're just going to be painting, whether you're using an aerosol can or brush or airbrush. However you're going to do that, you're basically just wanting to get your main colors down. So one thing that I do want to make sure to mention here is that it really is important to do multiple coats of paint, because one thing that may happen to you, it does occasionally happen to me as well if you're not thorough in getting a nice even coat of paint, is that once you get everything painted and you're putting some parts together, you may have two parts that are the same color right next to each other, but they're not quite exactly the same because you didn't get a good even coat over the whole thing. And so you may have one that looks just a little bit lighter or a little bit darker than the other. So making sure you do multiple coats will give you a good even color throughout all the parts, so you have that good consistency. Also, this may be when you're going to be doing masking, so you get your base coat down and then you want to mask and do some like two-tone or something like that, however you want to do that. One thing just to note about the important thing about masking is that before you put the masking tape on the part, you want to stick it to something else first to make it just a little bit less adhesive. Then stick it onto the parts just to make sure that when you peel that off, it's not going to peel up any paint or anything. Again, that's the important part of sanding and priming properly, so that you have a good connection there between the paint and the plastic. But again, just to be safe, make sure you take that proper step before you do any masking. The next step for me is then a top coat. Now, a top coat is a thing that I think you really need to understand why you do it again, and then you can understand if and whenever you need to do it in your process. So top coat, basically think of top coating as a way to just save your progress. Whatever you got down so far, you're just putting a layer on that to protect that, so that whatever you do next won't in any way damage that. So top coats, pretty much any top coat that you're going to be using is going to be lacquer based, so it's going to be stronger than either enamel or acrylic based paints, which are weaker. So anything you're doing using enamel or acrylic after that won't be damaged or won't be damaging your paint underneath, because you have that layer of lacquer in the top coat to be covering that. The thing about top coats is that not all top coats are actually forming a protective layer. They're basically, some of them are basically just like a clear paint, so it's not really going to have any different like protective properties than your paint that's underneath it. So you want to make sure you're using a top coat that does actually form some kind of protective layer over the paint, more than just giving you just a different finish. So what I use at this stage, and other people will use different things, but I've had a pretty good experience of using this recently, is Pledge Future Clear. It's like a household product from the America. I gotta give a big shout out to my friend here, another fellow expat Gunpla builder here in Korea, Paul, he sent me some of that. This stuff is great because it's really easy to use an airbrush. You just put it right in the airbrush and just spray it, and it goes on really nicely. It gives you not a super glossy finish, but it's like semi-gloss to a little bit just glossy enough for what you need. The good point of that is that it gives you a really good strong protective layer to protect your paint. So aside from protecting your paint, the other reason that you want a gloss coat at this stage, and especially use gloss coat, is because that gloss will be helpful for putting your panel lining and decals on, which we'll get to next. So the next thing then is the panel lining. So there's probably like a million different ways to panel line. There's a lot of different products that you can use. Some people use the pens or markers or pencils or inks or watercolor, or I don't think watercolor, but I'm sure some people probably do. Oils or acrylics or enamels, that's what I was trying to think of. If you're using something like this, Tamiya Accent Color, these are enamel based, so that's basically enamel thinner. So like I said, enamel in enamel thinner is not as strong as lacquer, so having your good lacquer based top coat down first will ensure that your enamel based panel lining will not mess up your paint. One reason why it's good to have that gloss coat down first before your panel lining wash is that glossy surface will help the paint, when you put it in the panel line, to just glide through the panel line with a little bit more easier. It's less friction for the paint to be up against when it's trying to flow through the panel lines. The other reason why I do panel lining at this step before I get into my detail painting is that panel lining, you will usually like give you a nice outline for when you want to do your detail painting. So if I have my panel lines already there and then I want to fill in one section with a small little detail, I just fill that in and then the outline of the black is already there, and this is kind of easier. So I've already done like a few videos on like detail painting with enamel paint. It's something that I've covered well enough before. You can check that out. But at this step is usually when I would do that, after panel lining and before decals. So then the next step, naturally, now at this point, is the water slide decals. So you can use different types of decals, but I'm just going to talk mostly about water slides because I think they're probably the most common that people are going to be using at this step. Again, this is where it is important to use a glossy top coat before, because that gloss finish will, again, give you a better surface for putting down your decals on. The one thing is that it's smooth, so if you put on your decal and you need to move it around a little bit, you have more ease to do that. Also, because any sort of rough surface underneath that decal will cause the decal to silver. It's called silvering. Basically, it just makes your decal look pretty shitty. So that is something that does happen occasionally, and it's just kind of unfortunate, and you hope it doesn't happen. But one of the ways that you can take a proper step to avoid that happening is by using that good gloss finish top coat before you put on your decals. All right, then for me, the next step at this point would be putting on another coat of top coat, because now I've got my panel lining and my detail painting and my decals done. I want to make sure all that is protected before I do anything else. So this is when I'll take that Future Clear again and just give this a nice coat of that strong protective top coat on there. Cover all that up, make sure all that is protected. Now at this point, basically what your mobile suit is kind of like fresh out of the factory. Everything is just like brand new on it, and it's totally clean, and all the decals are on there, and it's just like a totally new mobile suit. And so at this point is then when you can go in and do any sort of weathering or filtering or anything you want to do to make it look more like it has been in some use. So seeing as how this is kind of an optional step, and I usually don't tend to do a lot of weathering, some filtering, yes, but this is basically the step when you would want to do that, and you can get in and just dirty it up or filter it up to adjust your color tones and things like that. You can do that all at this step before moving into the final step, which would be one more coat of your protecting gloss coat on that. Of course, if you didn't do any weathering, then you don't need to do another coat. But if you did do any sort of weathering or filtering or anything at this step, then just throwing another coat of protective gloss coat on that. Get that all secure down, and then finally your final step will just be your final top coat, which doesn't really need to be protective. It can be just to give you whatever finish you want, whether that be matte, semi-gloss, or glossy, however you're gonna do that. Your final top coat will be going on that. That'll give you the final finish that you want for your kit, and then your kit's done. So that should give you a general outline of an idea, maybe of how you want to go about your steps for painting. Again, you can adjust that for what you need. Again, for example, if you aren't going to be doing any weathering, like I said, you don't need to do that. If you do your panel lining and your detail painting and you really are wanting to make sure that that's protected even before you get into your decals, you can do an extra coat of top coat at that time. It just all depends on what works for you. Just remember, top coat is basically just a way to just save your progress on the kit. Primer is definitely necessary for multiple reasons before you're going to be painting your full kit, so don't forget to do that. To all of this, basically, there's a million different exceptions and different ways to do everything. Again, this is just kind of my workflow, how I go about it, and I think kind of the most basic, common way to go about it. You can do whatever works for you using whatever products you have available to you or whichever steps you want to do to make your kit your own. But hopefully this has been helpful for you guys, and hopefully will help to answer some of the questions you had about the order of when you're going to be doing these different steps on your kit. So if you guys still have any other questions or comments, again, leave all of that down below. Let's have some discussion about this in the comment section. And thank you guys for watching. See you next time.
Thanks for watching. See you next time.